厦门大学美籍教授潘维莲是福建省第一位拥有在华永久居留权的外国人。近期他荣获感动中国2019年度人物。作为中美两国新冠肺炎疫情亲历者的潘维莲，从美国回到中国两个多月后谈起了自己的抗疫经历。今年年初，64岁的潘维莲趁寒假回美国探亲，他一直持续关注着新冠肺炎相关消息。三月初，潘维莲向厦门大学提出返校申请。当月21日，他携家人回到厦门。
And if my wife and I did not return then, it might be a long time before we had another chance. And today it's clear that I was right. I wasn't right because I was smart. I was right because I was confident.
1988年，32岁的潘维莲来到了福建，成为厦门大学一名外教。旅居厦门30余年，潘维莲每次和妻子回到福建家中都感到十分开心快乐，而这次回来尤其让他感到安心。
China, unlike the rest of the world, is safe for two reasons. One, the government has shown that it can make clear decisions based on science, not politics, and efficiently and unwaveringly lead the entire nation in the fight. Unlike other countries where national, state, and local leaders have turned this tragedy into a political war. And two, China's people are pragmatic and support their government because they have confidence that their government is concerned about lives more than money.
在中国疫情初期，许多美国友城向福建省伸出援手。华盛顿州塔科马市向福州市捐赠了5040支 N95 口罩。当美国友城遭遇疫情时，福建也给美国友城打气。截至四月底，福建共向美国俄勒冈州、弗吉尼亚州、宾夕法尼亚州以及纽约州捐赠了20万支医用口罩。这种互致慰问、互帮互助，让潘维莲感到欣慰。
Given the world's immature response to this crisis and how they are trying to blame China for their own ineptness, I'm thankful that China and even my own province of Fujian is still persisting in helping those nations by sending medical supplies. Such mutual support reassures me that in spite of the politicians' games, the common people see what is really happening and are still concerned about each other.
关于病毒，仍有诸多未知。潘维莲认为需要做的事情还有很多。他提出，国际友城的市长、官员们需保持开放坦诚的态度，互相沟通，交流成功经验与失败教训。